Ladies Haven's very happy to call him one of our own. So please welcome comedian Vinny Beedle.
What's going on, everybody? Come on, get your hands going right now, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight? We doing good over here? I want to feel like a rock and roll star up here. You guys ain't nobody can't slap. Who am I gonna slap? Come on, bro. Go get some. I don't bite. I ain't gonna play up here. Let's go. How's everybody? Queen. Thank you. Yeah, let's go. Yay. Let's cue the. Jeez, what are you guys trying to blind me? I can't see nobody. How's everybody doing tonight? We doing good? Everybody really needs to give each other the opportunity to put your hands together right now for all coming out for this great benefit. We got the, the people in a morgue inside that lost their homes. That's terrible. We got the people helping people. I don't know what people are helping what people yet. We're going to sort that out after the show. Those of you who want to be helped, get in one line. And those of you who want to help, get in another line. How you guys doing? This is kind of funny because usually when I do comedy, I do, shows like this, but I do a lot of stuff at comedy clubs. So usually when you got like 4 or 5 people going up here with beautiful voices, you got me coming up, it's not too much fun. How you doing, ma'am? Guys, this is it's a good time. We're here, we're collecting money for people, who really need it right now. So I went to East Haven High School. And, it was weird. I got bullied a lot, when I was growing up. I would always hear it from the bus stop all the way to school. I would always hear, you're an idiot, little fat boy, what are you doing? And it's just like, Grandma, I'm trying to go to school. I don't know why you gotta, be such a mean lady all the time. She was just it's kind of messed up. I'm gonna let you guys know right now, I usually do a lot of cursing, but I'm not gonna swear just in case I can't see any little kids in the back or anything like that. So, can we clap for me right now for not swearing? It's a little tough. You know what comedy is like without swear words? It's like the D.A.R.E. program without Officer Mike. Look at how we're making out right now. We're not doing so hot. Yeah. You know what though, it's good. I like to see a bunch of people from our community coming together, and they're not coming together to do illegal things in the town. You know what I mean? We're doing some good. I like to see that. It's very fun. I was a little bit chubbier in high school and stuff. I know, it's not a weird segue, but we're gonna get into that. We're gonna start talking about myself in high school. And I was a little bit chubby. I wasn't invited to the pool parties because I had to wear like a one-piece suit when I would go swimming. And the weird thing about the one-piece suit was that I have a 6-year-old nephew. When I would come out of the bathroom dressed and ready to go to the beach or go to a pool party or something, he thought I looked like Andre the Giant, which was kind of weird. 6-year-old. Nobody knows Andre the Giant. I've seen a lot of elderly people in here. Seemed like you might as well have been to middle school with him or something. Remember the tall kid in middle school? That was Andre the Giant. Yeah. East Haven. So, a lot of people say they don't. Tell me how many times you guys hear that nobody likes living in East Haven. Everybody says, I don't like it. I'm going to move. I can't stand it no more. I actually like living in East Haven because when I went to high school, all my friends were all very muscular and tan, much like you see on MTV's The Jersey Shore. Woo, yeah, they're okay. Yeah, they're all right. That's not me though. When I was in high school, I was round and white. I was like a gallon of milk, I didn't really fit in. The only girls that liked me were ones that really liked cookies, so I was kind of I was left out of it a lot. I mean, if any girls really like cookies and they're at the age of 65 and they're, I would love to meet you after the show. You know what? I don't even care. If you're 65 and you like cookies, you can come say what's up to me. I might talk to you. I'll give you a little something to think about. You know what I love the most about this show? I wanted to do it because I wanted to show you guys that I'm not just out there swearing at bars underage and doing weird things. I want to show you what I can give back to my community. And coming to East Haven, do this show, it really gave me a lot of redemption. I was hoping some of my teachers would be here tonight. When I was in high school, they all told me, Vinny, you can't just stand there and make jokes. You're never going to get anywhere in life. And it's like, you're kind of wrong about that. You guys asked me to come do a show at the high school, so it's a little bit of good redemption there, right? It's not too bad. All right. So you know what? I'm going to send a little message out there if there's any students out here tonight to just know that no matter what your teacher says, don't listen to them and follow your dreams. And college is overrated and expensive. And most of the time when you go there, all you're going to do is drink beer and play video games and not go to class and get into other things that we don't want to talk about right now. We'll let Officer Mike with the D.A.R.E. program handle that. Okay. So, I just rambled for a couple minutes. Yeah, that was nice. East Haven. So I mean, like I said, you know, I was a little chubby kid growing up. I got bullied. Even in school was a little rougher because I was kind of, I couldn't get shoved in the locker. They would shove me in closets. It was still a little tight. I couldn't really. I'm so hard. There's nothing really else to talk about besides myself and all swearing, besides making fun of the fact that it's a little chubbier. I was just gonna sit down here for a minute. Oh, we got the people helping people here right out in front. This is awesome. So you guys are the ones helping or getting help. If you wear the shirt, you're like, listen, I'm wearing the shirt. I need the help. I think I might need the help. I think that's what, you think so? What do you think? You think I should have went to college? Do you think I should have did this and came here tonight? You're saying yes, man. I asked you a question, I gave you an answer. She's like, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Should I have went to college or should I have came here tonight? Mm-hmm. You go right ahead, honey. We're helping people. The light is really bright. I can't really look into it. We got a lot of people. Is there more than 12 people? I can only see up here. We got people, make some noise back there. We're live. We're live tonight. Yeah, guy, what's up? You know what? What a cool variety show. But you know what? Have you noticed just a bunch of musicians and then like some comic randomly coming up? What kind of variety is that? At least you should have had a band with like a black guitarist and like an Asian drummer. You could have made like the flyer for this show like a college brochure. That would have been variety. That's what I'm talking about. All right, well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give the show back to Felicia. Let's put our hands together for Felicia. Thank you guys very much.